You know, the important thing about prayer is if you're really experienced in it, then you end up doing something that Charles Finney described as prevailing prayer. Prevailing prayer is when you know your prayer has gotten where it's got to go. Let me just say this. I travel around the United States. I'm involved with a great deal of media, doing meetings and such. I'll tell you, there's a lot of anxious praying. There's a lot of hopeful praying. But right now, we need prevailing prayers. We need the old-time warriors to get out there and push this issue through into the courts of heaven, if you will, so that we can have the peace that no matter what's going on down here, God has heard. Because if he hears us, we'll have the thing we desired. Paul said, I desire that, first of all, you pray for those that are in authority. Not second, not third, not maybe I'll get involved with the government. First order of priority, pray for rulers, because they determine the ecosystem for the church, the environment we operate in. So, Father, we pray, first of all, for rulers. You're the one that puts them up and you put them down. We pray in this season of hopeful change that you will put up and you will put down, and that you will grant an extension of grace and mercy to these United States, not because, Lord, we deserve it, but because in your goodness and kindness, you're willing to extend mercy and grace so that the church, being properly energized, can begin to do what it's needed to do for many years, to rise up as an influential moral force in this country and in the world. Nations are praying for the United States. Nations are hoping we don't go down. I pray, God, for one great, final, extraordinary move of God in our lifetime. Those of us that are older, that have prayed for revival, let us see it with our eyes and feel it with our hands and behold it, Lord, as a great awakening in the United States of America. Let this hour be the hour that the birth of the nation actually happens in intercession and in the preaching of great awakening, in Jesus' name. And everyone out there said, amen. And I hear you say, amen.